Hello everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to do one-way ANOVA and two-way ANOVA. So what we're really seeing right now is a data file prepared by a group of students. So they are analyzing a social media platform, and they have this this consumer data here at this point you see here, and they have quite a bit of variables. Actually the data file is pretty good. They have collected from 60 users this data file. So one of the variables this group is interested in number of likes, because that's something is important for number of likes for the research. And what else we have in this case is, so I'm not going to go entire data set. My purpose is to show how to do a test, but I'm quickly show you what variables they have at this point here. So they have a few variables at the end. These are the coded variables. One variable is the duration. So duration is basically is you see this variable here. This is number of years person been on social media actually. So this is a skill variable. You can see there's a little skill here, and now this skill has been recoded into a duration. So the durations are, they have a three durations, yeah, 1, 2, 3, and one group is 0 to 5 years, two is between 6 and 8 years, and third is 9+ years. And one of the way this duration was grouped into three categories is to making sure that there is enough people. And so approximately the number of duration was divided into three equal part. Approximately, of course, it's not going to be exactly 1/3 each, but approximately. Okay. So I'm going to use this this data to show you how to analyze their one-way ANOVA. So you click on analyze, okay. And because we're comparing a mean of three duration categories of number of likes, so we go on one-way ANOVA, and then we select number of likes, the dependent list, and you see the number of likes is a scale variable, very important. And then we have this duration as a factor. So this is factor, and so factor has to be very important, has to be either categorical, must be categorical variable. So within categorical variable, you can have a ordinal. So this is ordinal scale. Okay, you can see this one, the duration is ordinal. Ordinal means that this category could be order. So obviously, one is smaller than two, two is smaller than three. So there's hierarchy going on here. And that's what we need to do here. And before we run, before we say okay, go on the post-hoc. The post-hoc test is done when the ANOVA shows significance. Significance, that means there is a difference in the group means. So just in case if the ANOVA shows a significance value, the p-value is less than 5%, then we want to see which groups are different. So I check on the Tukey test. That's what you need to do here. And I also check on the options. They give you some interesting statistics, like descriptive statistics, which kind of show you the what is the mean likes by those three duration categories. Homogeneity variance test is to ensure that the ANOVA assumption is met, that variances are same across three categories. And that's all I do. I don't do a plot here because I'm going to show you how to do make a nicer plot than the plot is produces here. So you say continue, and you say okay. So you see now we got this nice one-way ANOVA results, and the first part you see is called descriptive. So it's basically descriptive statistics. So you can see there is 0 to 5 showing the mean value. So mean value seems to be pretty high. It's showing like over 4 million actually. You can see the 4.2 million. And the number of likes for between for the age 6 to 8 years is about 319,000 likes, and then we have this over 1 million, slightly 1 million. So obviously you can see that there is some difference showing up here, and then the one test which I want to show you before I show you, just to show you that test of homogeneity variances, then based on the median value, you see that the p value is more than 2.91. So this indicate that the groups are fairly homogeneous. Okay, so this is fine, and so this is your ANOVA test. Okay, So I'm going to draw your attention very quickly to this sig, SIG sig value. This sig value is really is your p value, which is 0.294, which is way more than 5%. So statistically speaking, there is no difference between those three groups of duration of the average like. So there is no significant difference. So because there is no significant difference, so this post hoc test, this test will not be much use because there is no significant difference. And so therefore, what I want to show you is, so in terms of the final conclusion, it seems there is some interesting differences in mean value. However, statistically speaking, there is no significant difference. So this is your one-way ANOVA. So it's quite very common that when we show a one-way ANOVA, we also tend to also show our bar chart. So I'm going to show you how to do a bar chart. Okay, so you go on the graph. Click the chart builder and you say okay here, and it will show you this window here. So you click onto the bar chart and you select your number of likes on a y-axis and duration on your x-axis. So this is what shows up here. You say, you know what, you want to see the mean value. And that's pretty much it. And then you say okay, and then you have this bar chart. And of course, one of the things you want to do is just to also show you the values, so which is common practice to show those values. So you can click on the bar chart and say I want to see this value. So you have this nice value shows up here, and obviously you can see that obviously people who are relatively newer in this social media site, they generally tend to do more liking compared to those who are in a longer duration. So this is very even though it's not significant difference, and I'm afraid that one of the reason why we don't see a result as very significant, you can see that the significance p-value is 0.294, which is way more than 5%. Because I also think that is also because of the sample size. You can see that the degrees of freedom is 58. So sample size is relatively few. So it's about 60. But one interesting thing you notice here is this: is those who are who are relatively new in this platform, they tend to like they have average like of 4.2. millions compared to the other two categories. So that's even though it's not significant difference, but this is definitely is a very interesting point to mention, that that the members who are relatively newer, they tend to do more liking than those who are in other categories. So this is how you do your one-way ANOVA and the supporting graph. Okay, I'm going to show you how to do two-way ANOVA. So let's quickly go back to the data set this group has. So again, we're going to focus on this variable, the number of likes, and we already have identified this duration as a one factor. But perhaps we can also look at another factor, which is called tagging. Has the person has been tagged or not tagged, for example. So I think this is interesting. And again, where does this really variable come from? This comes from number of tags. So we have recoded number of tags into a yes or no. So you can say if the person was tagged is 1, if not tagged is 0. Okay, so that's what we see here. And then I'm going to show you how to do a two-way ANOVA using tagging and duration as a two factors against the number of likes. So watch how I'm going to do that. So you go and analyze, okay, click on the general linear model univariate, and then you select your dependent variable here, number of likes. Okay, then you select those two factors which we identify. Okay, so tagging is one factor and duration is another factor. Okay, I will suggest that you select two factor at a time, and I also want to advise that try not to have too many labels in your factor, because one of the problems is if you have too many labels, then the data thin out, and then it not be very suitable. So you also want to make sure that, of course, you want to make sure that you have at least two categories of labels in your each of those factors, and there's enough sufficient number of cases in each of those labels. Otherwise, result will not be meaningful, and you might not even get any output if there's not enough people. Okay, And also not to have too many labels in each of your factors you chose. So as you know that in tagging there's only two labels, yes or no. In membership there's a three duration of those memberships. Okay, and so we want to go on the plot. The plot typically is very useful, especially if you want to see interaction effect. So I'm going to select the duration on a horizontal axis and tagging on a separate line. Okay, and I'm going to say add. So this is an interaction plot between tagging and duration. Okay, then I'm going to say continue. And again, the post hoc test is just in case if the one of the factors are significant that you want to see which one is significant. And as you know, the tagging has only two labels, yes or no. So if the test shows it's significant, then we know that there's significant difference between yes or no. So therefore, we're not going to choose the tagging as a post hoc test, but we're going to choose a duration because your duration, as you know, has three labels. Okay, and we're going to again apply a Tukey test. And we continue here, and in the option it will again show you a bunch of stats. I always go for some of the descriptive stats. It's always nice to got some bunch of descriptive stats. Homogeneity of variance test is also useful just to make sure that the assumptions are met, and then and don't worry about any other things we see here, and that's pretty much it. And don't worry to select any other variables here because we're not at this point studying any other factors or covariate factor. Then we're going to say okay. And then you see this output comes out of 2 way ANOVA. So again, these are simple descriptive statistics. You can definitely say what is the tagging, those who tagged yes or no, and how those averages look like by the membership duration. So these are some of the mean values. So it's always a good idea to kind of study these mean values. It's helpful. I want to once again go back to the living test. Again, living test looks promising. Then based on the mean, the homogeneity variance test is valid. So data is okay for us to use. This output is very important. This is a two-way ANOVA output, and remember we have this tagging variable whether person tagged or no tagged. Okay. And you can see the p-value is 0.246. So again, it's not significant at 5% level. Alpha is 5%, p-value is 0.246. But it's still relatively a small p-value. Of course, not significant because it's way more than 5%. But if you look at the duration in this, when we're comparing two variables, duration is not significant at all. It's, the p-value is 0.613, and compared to 5%, it's way, way, very, very high. Now I want to draw attention to the tagging interaction with duration. So this is interaction effect, and you see that the significance is 0.542. Again, it's not significant, but interesting thing is this is when duration was interacted with tagging, the p-values has come down slightly. So this is interesting to note. Okay, and then continue to go down. If you look at the multiple comparison, again, multiple comparison has no use to us because we already know that duration is not significant because p-value is 0.613. Okay, I want to show you this chart. This is a very interesting chart. This is called interaction plot. And just mind you that interaction is not significant because we can see that the p-value is 0.542. However, what is interesting to note here is this. You can let me expand this chart here. So it looks kind of much, much better. So this is the light blue is the no, those who tagged. So you can notice that, so again, on the x-axis is the duration. So you can notice that those who did not tag, they tend to have a slightly way more like than who do not like. So definitely you can see that there is a very difference between these two groups. But what interesting thing is those who are not tagged, as the duration goes up, the average number of tagging has dropped. I shouldn't use the word significantly because we don't know that. But definitely is a huge drop from like 6 million to way less. You can, this is a huge drop. Whereas those who've been tagged, there's no drop. It's pretty much kind of flat. You know, I mean, it's a slight increase, but it's pretty much flat. And for those who did not tag, at duration goes up, then the slightly goes up. Whereas for the yes, so there is still not big change. So it's very interesting that how those who tagged and how durations, how they're interacting with the duration. So this is a very interesting plot. As I said, this is not significant, but definitely it's very interesting. The time said we definitely see there is a very interesting interaction happening, but unfortunately this interaction is not statistically significant. So this is how you do your one-way ANOVA, two-way ANOVA. So give a try to your own data and try this way out. Oh, I hope you find it useful and able to practice using your own data. Bye bye.